This is funny. Around the same time after Battlefield 1's launch, I complained that automatic weapons didn't feel consistent enough, and I felt like they needed to have their accuracy tightened up a little bit. But in this video, I think Battlefield 5 might have an effective range problem, where guns are so useful outside of what I believe should be their effective range that it doesn't quite feel right. Now, if you like the gunplay in Battlefield 5, you and I are in the same group. I love the gunplay in Battlefield 5, but I feel like some guns are too versatile at too many different ranges, and that's probably due to predictive recoil, the time to kill, and the really, really high headshot multiplier. Those things come together and I think they create something of a problem. It's not ruining the game for me, it's not something I need patched by the end of this week, otherwise I'm gonna be mad, but it's something I'd like DICE to look into. Using the Sten at mid to long range isn't as unusable as I'd probably like it to be. The gun just feels like it's too versatile. Now up close, I feel like it's balanced because of its lower rate of fire, but at a distance, that lower rate of fire means that tap firing it at people, I don't know, I just feel like it's a little too effective. Same with stuff like the STG-44 or the Sturmgewehr 1.5. Also, when it comes to semi-autos, the Gewehr 43, or is it 34? I always get those numbers mixed up, but the Gewehr semi-automatic rifle is really, really good. And yet, the Model 8 in the sniper category just doesn't quite feel as good as the Gewehr. Like, it just doesn't. It just feels like the rate of fire is all over the place, and the accuracy doesn't feel good. Maybe you're having a different experience when it comes to individual weapons and how they perform in specific situations, but in Battlefield 5, we don't have a normal mini-map. We don't have 3D spotting for every class. We don't even have 3D spotting from squad leaders or squad members. We don't have traditional spotting. We also don't show up on the mini-map when we fire unsuppressed guns because there are no suppressed guns. I don't know if they want to go the extra mile and do suppressors on SMGs like Call of Duty World War II did, but a lot of people wouldn't like that. They're already mad that the multiplayer doesn't feel as authentic as possible, so adding suppressors might be the final nail in the coffin. Some people are mad about the reflex sights. Not because they didn't exist, but because they weren't often used, and I don't know, most of Battlefield 1's arsenal to me felt like weapons that weren't often used, but still, whatever. But anyway, I'm talking about suppressors, and when it comes down to suppressors, you might be wondering what the hell does that have to do with effective ranges. Well, the thing is, in a Battlefield game, if you show up on the minimap while shooting, taking somebody out outside of your effective range was a bit challenging. You see, you could totally get away with long-range kills with assault rifles and even SMGs and LMGs without bipodding them or anything. You could get away with it in games like Battlefield 3, 4, and Hardline because of lower recoil, higher DPS, all of that. You know, an M416 is a very versatile gun. Even me using the UMP in Battlefield 4, it's pretty damn versatile. The thing is, those games allowed you to suppress your guns, and why that's important is that when you fire your gun outside of your effective range, you're going to have to use more shots than normal, meaning you will be on the minimap longer while trying to take somebody outside of your effective range. So now that that's not really something you have to worry about, because back in Battlefield 3, 4, and Hardline, if you wanted to stay off the minimap while, you know, taking out people, you had to put on a suppressor, which nerfed your effective range and your bullet velocity. So you could stay off the minimap and use your gun, but you would, you know, sacrifice performance, and that's something that you don't have to worry about in Battlefield 5. You're just not gonna show up on the minimap most of the time. So when I'm sitting in a building in Battlefield 5, you know, peppering somebody with 30 Sten rounds to get a kill at long range, you know, people might be able to see my tracers. If there isn't a lot of gunfire around, they might be able to hear where I am, but I'm not going to be exposing my real-time position on the minimap by peppering an entire magazine off into the hills across the map with an SMG. So because there's no trade-off where if you don't want to be in the minimap, throw in a suppressor, we're just always off the minimap, people feel a lot more confident taking the time to pepper you with bullets, again, outside of their effective range. I'm going to say that so many times in this video, everyone's going to hate me. Also take into account that suppression doesn't affect your weapon accuracy, so when you're suppressed, you're not going to be, you know, missing your shots because somebody's shooting at you. Meaning, if somebody at a distance starts shooting at you with an LMG or a sniper rifle or an assault rifle, a semi-automatic rifle, an SMG, a pistol, whatever, you can't turn and start shooting back at them and throw them off their aim. And now that you don't really worry about suppressing people to throw off their accuracy and blur their vision, you are just, you know, trying to kill them, it seems a lot more, I don't want to say arcadey or twitch shootery, but that's kind of what it is. I can no longer suppress people at a distance, and people aren't trying to suppress me at a distance, they're trying to kill me. But between not showing up on the minimap, the headshot multiplier, the time to kill in general, the accuracy, they're not gonna be, you know, they're not gonna want to suppress you. That's not their goal anymore. Their goal is to kill you with their gun, and it's very, very possible. And again, if an LMG user starts pinning you down at long range, you can't return fire. In fact, you shouldn't even be popping your head up. They'll most likely mow you down if they're bipodded. Some people are gonna love this because they believe it to be more realistic or at least more skill-based, whatever side of the fence you're on. Some people are always saying some stupid shit like that. The thing is I think that there needs to be some bullet bloom at range, more so than there is currently. And I also do think that suppression should go back to reducing accuracy at long range. And this would be tweaked on a gun-to-gun basis. What I mean by that is that SMGs would start to suppress at a shorter range than an LMG or a sniper rifle. LMGs and sniper rifles would have to be way the fuck back to start suppressing you, whereas assault rifles would be a little bit closer, and then SMGs and pistols would be the closest. Meaning that an SMG wouldn't have to be as far away to start suppressing you because it's an SMG. They don't have a lot of ammo, they don't have a lot of damage. The least they should be able to do is to reduce your accuracy by like 5% in a last-ditch effort to not get shot at by you, or not get shot at by you as accurately. So adding on some more bullet bloom at range I think would be a good idea, especially for stuff like semi-autos and LMGs. Not so much on maybe SMGs and pistols, and of course not sniper rifles. Because those guns, you know, all you know, they don't need to be like less effective at long range. Snipers need to be effective at long range, and SMGs and pistols aren't going to be anyway. And then have suppression work like the way it used to, maybe, you know, heavily reduced from how it used to, but have it work the way it used to at a longer range. So like, you won't be as accurate at long range, but you will be able to throw off people's accuracy at those longer ranges. You might not be able to consistently melt people. You'll still be able to kill people at long range. I don't want that to change. But you won't be able to consistently melt people at long range. In fact, your weapon at long range would be more of a suppression tool, and I kind of feel like that's how it should be when it comes to assault rifles, LMGs, and semi-autos. You can let me know what you think in the comment section below, but to summarize this entire video, I think the effective ranges on weapons need to be tweaked, and I think the best way to do that would be to add some bloom at long range and add in some old-fashioned battlefield suppression. I think this would balance out because, yeah, you won't be hitting every shot, but your suppression will be more useful on top of spotting enemies, because suppression, of course, spots enemies. So you won't be a super awesome killing machine at a distance, but you will still be able to be effective in a different way. And hopefully still be rewarded for your ability to pace shots and lead targets at a distance. There's tons of things they could do, but I just think that something needs to change. Again, they could do a lot of things. They could make it so that your bullets move slower. They could make it so that you only have bloom out to like 100 meters. Everything within that is like super predictive recoil. They could just leave it the way it is and I can suck it up. Tons of options. So anyway, let me know what you think in the comment section below. Hopefully you watched to this point in the video. If you watched till the end, let me know, and I will see you when I see you. Goodbye.